He blurs the lines in terms of what is possible from certain areas. All the talent in the world. But against Marlon, how can you make those chances for yourself? Because he is the master of suffocation. The master of making you feel uncomfortable, making you feel like you can't really play how you want to play.
Only player to ever complete a career double Grand Slam.
Left, one, four.
Now in the twilight, you might argue, of his career. Still a world number three. Gozzi can snatch something here. We then go into a fourth match where Felix LeBron has another opportunity.
Comes back in to block Gozzi. Punch as well.
3-1.
Had it all there, but the movement was so dynamic.
Look at this.
That's what you've got to do there. He didn't keep wanting to loop to loop. He knew his only chance was if he came in closer.
Yeah, he decided he was going to take the initiative. I like the way he started this match. To be fair to France, they've really been very positive today, haven't they?
Of course. That's their style, that's their nature. They know they have to intimidate China. Look at these backhands here. Unbelievable from Gozzi.
That was an earlier point. That so impressed us. And then he comes in.
3-1.
Four-point lead here for Gozzi.
Look at that for a serve. Because he never saw that coming.
Just no space to manoeuvre.
Oh. 6-2.
Well, if you're ever going to beat Marlon, it's going to be when he's in the final chapter. And he's announced that himself, Marlon.
Yeah, there were emotional scenes in Durban last year at the World Champs. And a lovely speech in both Mandarin and English. He was basically signing off. And he will be dearly missed.
He will be. He really, really will be.
6 points clear, Simon Gozzi. Last year, he very publicly said he feels a lot less pressure now. As we said in the final chapter, the twilight of his career. Got his family to think about now. He's enjoying, he said, his table tennis more.
Only lost one match in 2015, and it was to a teammate, Shang Kun, in the Japan Open.
That's how good he was. That's how good he is still. In his heyday, no one could come close. To go right down that edge, below the table.
Look at this here. Nice touch from Gozzi. Marlon letting the ball drop more so he can actually get more dwell. You're encouraged to take it early, but that isn't always the case. Coming back in here.
Just narrowing that lead. Points in it. Oh, right off the edge there on that corner.
He breathes a deep breath there, Gozzi. There was some relief there.
Yeah.
So crafty. So cunning from Marlon here.
The first of four game points saved. Seymour Gozzi takes the first game here against Marlon.
Marlon in three consecutive world championships. Marlon could have won five or six if it wasn't for him.
Yeah.
But no hard feelings. It's all done for the greater good of Team China.
Let's see how he bounces back, Marlon. Lost to Lee Sung-soo. He's coming back here nicely. He ended that last game pretty positively, didn't he? Even though he lost it. And he's kept that momentum going into this one.
I honestly don't think a French player has ever beaten Marlon. Because the LeBruns haven't done it.
Mm.
Alexis hasn't done it. Felix. Gozzi's never done it. Leveson never did it. And the ones that were playing before this trio, to my knowledge, never did it either. He treats European players like a doormat, Marlon. It was Timo Boll, who was and still is one of the most respected players by Team China, who showed it was possible time and time again, and also Vladimir Samsonov.
Well, this is more the Marlon that people might be used to. Well, that's a great way to get your first point on the board. He's far behind, though, Gozzi.
There's some respite there by giving Marlon a whiplash. Revved over that one. Both seeing some incredible step-arounds, pivots. Ooh.
2-5.
Now, Gozzi has a shot there that Marlon doesn't play. But the forehand of Marlon is unparalleled.
6-2.
I mean, for all intents and purposes, this is effectively the last World Championship match you're going to see of Marlon.
Maybe he'll play Qatar singles next year.
No, I think that's it.
Really?
That was what the speech was all about in Durban.
What?
That was so low down for LeBron. For Gozzi, excuse me. The LeBruns have been doing stuff like that as well all day. But that was just too low, wasn't it? A He's surging. He's really in control here, Ma Long.
He's turned this match on its head because it was almost an identical start from Gauzy in the first game. The last game, but Ma Long learns so quickly, doesn't he? Snatching there, Gauzy. Frustrated. And 8 game points to the Dragon.
10-2.
What a way to end that.
And that's because of his creativity and flair. His consistency, his ability to improvise. Gauzy, a man who's even beaten Shushin. The 2019 World Championships in Budapest, where he reached the quarter-final. But it's Ma Long's timelessness. He's seen so many legendary threats come and go, and he's outlived, outlasted them all. The best in the face of adversity. A true student of the game with such a youthful spirit.
2-1.
Stamps his authority through that one. Is this the turning point?
Yeah, I think safe to say. Ma Long, that one was a real big message from him in the second game.
Look at this, if the serve...
That's classic, isn't it, Ma Long?
Yeah, if the serve is at all predictable, which only really would be for the very, very best. It's over.
Well, on the left there is Xiao Shuyuan, our Olympic gold medalist at the Rio Games. Next to her is her partner, Jun Li, also a para table tennis player. How often do we see this when a Chinese player has been stung? He repays you back with interest and then some.
It's like you're prodding at the bee's nest,
yeah,
isn't it?
Exactly.
You're almost asking for it.
Gauzy's on the receiving end right now. There's a little message to be sent back.
Scurries out there, Ma. The speed from Gauzy, though.
Yeah, he's got that, hasn't he?
It's all over it. Like a rash.
Where are you seeing... We just talked about the Olympics. Where do you see Gauzy's part in the Olympics?
Well, Felix, for me, is a guaranteed first. I mean, you'd imagine that Alexei will be at number two, right? But there isn't that many differences in ranking between Gauzy and Alexei. I mean...
That performance just now... Shows you what he can do.
Exactly. That said.
Look at that. 23 of the last 32. Ma Long's way.
Gauzy took Fan Jendong to 5 games at the Olympics, at the team event. Not much between him and Alexei.
7-4.
You could see him in other disciplines, though, other sub events.
100% the team event, right? I mean, this is the indication. Being number 3, and will Ma Long be?
Look where you are. Yeah.
Will Ma Long be number three, or will he be there in singles with a chance to win his third gold? Mm. Raining down.
Yeah, looked a little nonplussed by that. Does he? There's pace on that one from Ma Long. Far away.
Each one of the best lobbers in the game, Gozi. It was nice to see Jim Mitsutani up here in the
next
medium area. Yeah.
Yeah.
He was one of them as well.
10-4.
Six game points now for Ma Long. He looks a different animal from where he was in that first one. What a story.
One love.
You just can't help but be in armor of this man.
Three big points here in this potential final game. Unless Gozi can do something here.
It's a must-win game. Gozi sometimes plays a lot better when he's losing.
Yeah. He needs to do something pretty soon, though.
This is so good. It's not the special things, it's not the flamboyant things that are making the difference here. It's the subtle things. It's a little bit more deception in Ma Long's game. A lot of Europeans try to go for deception in a more extreme way. Mm. But with China, they are the best at the simple things. They're the best at making it simple, which is actually a very hard thing to do. But once you develop your technique in this way, you've done the hard bit. Two big brothers of this team, or their teams rather.
Six, three.
Lead of three here for Ma Long.
Ooh.
His first World Team Championship coming in 2006 in Bremen. He's got a whopping 8 Team Championship goals.
And this would be his 14th overall World Table Tennis Championship gold. Brilliant switch from Gozzi.
Yeah, lovely on the back end, down the line.
Gone for it again, Matt. Square to the table. Just to find that forehand, the wider forehand of Marnos. Too wide, but wide enough.
There will be only a couple of points left, maybe.
The pancake flip. Comes in looking like he's going to push it and plays it flat. So tricky. Oh, and here we go.
4 championship points now for Ma Long and China. Dragon, it's fitting that the